Welcome back, guys. So I played Legend of Grimrock 2 on the channel, and then I played The Fall of the Dungeon Guardians. And now it's time to play The Quest, yet another sort of callback to the first-person dungeon crawler genre that had its heyday quite a while ago. This game actually originally came out, I believe, in 2009, I think. But it had a long history of being on phones and tablets and so on. And it just recently came to Steam as a PC game. So it's having... Maybe it'll have a whole new life. It is certainly for me, because this is the first I've heard of it. Just because in the... Yeah, phone games just kind of don't exist for me. Sorry. A few weeks ago, some very disturbing news came from the island of Freymore, a far section of Mersant's kingdom. Word is, the governor is missing or sick. The island is in tumult. The mages, all prophesy, the dark shadow looming over the safety of the kingdom. Majesty, we have received news from the island of Freymore. Governor Hume hasn't been seen for weeks. Some think he's dead. Some think he's gone in secret to a healer because he has some dread disease. The military has locked down his castle. I suggest we send out some of our agents to find out what's going on. Another thing, Majesty. Zerio, your counselor of the magic ministry, suggests we send a specific person, a newcomer to your military. He says it concerns an ancient prophecy called the Returning. I was struck by the fear and awe in his voice. Since then, he's gone into a trance and no one can talk to him. I will take his suggestion seriously, Zero's request and concerns are quite remarkable. I feel this means much more than the governor's possible sickness. Prepare the newcomer to depart immediately. I beg your pardon, Majesty. The newcomer isn't ready. He still needs weeks, maybe months, to conduct himself like a kingdom agent. I must still accept Zerio's suggestion. The wisdom of the old arts instructs his decisions. If this newcomer is something special, he'll live, and may be of some help to us. Zerio has never been wrong before. But actually, who is this newcomer?
Character generation!
Let's see what our options are. We have race, gender, so you can do male or female. Does not affect the avatar over here, so you still pick one from scratch no matter what you name, what gender your character is. Races, skills. Let's see, this should involve your actual class. There we go. Let's start here. And then we can pick a race that benefits that if we want to. So we can go for fighter, heavy weapon, heavy armor, light weapon, dual wield, block repair, all the straightforward melee punchy attacks. Thief, lighter equipment, an emphasis on ranged attacks. Yep, accuracy is ranged weapons. Stealth, lockpicking, disarm, more or less what you'd expect. Mage, virtually every possible type of magic you'd expect, really. Healing, protection, attack, magic, environment magic, alchemy. The Battle Mage trades some of that for some equipment, which I think sounds appealing. I think Mage will add some nice variety to the gameplay in this game, so I think I might want to go for Battle Mage. Let's see, attack and protection magic, mind magic. No healing magic is a noteworthy difference there, but you get light weapon, light armor, and block. And that distinction may be handy. Ranger? Similar to the thief, but with just more. Is it just the alchemy thing, really? Oh yeah, there's no stealth and disarming stuff. It's more of a combat rogue. And then priest is all defensive magic across the board, and hopefully planning on sweet talking people, I suppose. So it says select a predetermined class and/or modify the primary skills. So selecting battle mage gave us this preset. I take that's kind of a suggestion of some sort. But it looks like I can click on these to switch them, just change them out for anything. So our options are block, light and heavy weapons, dual wield, light and heavy armor, accuracy, healing, protection, attack, mind, undead, environmental, magic, repair, appraise, alchemy, persuasion, lockpick, disarm, stealth. Alright. Curious about undead magic, that didn't really come up. Influences the effect of undead spells, governed by intelligence. Can only be learned by undead. Oh, you have to play as an undead. It doesn't really say what undead magic means. Governed by personality, mind magic, environments, environmental magics governed by intelligence, attack, protection, and healing. Oh, attack and protection are learned by intelligence. Healing magic cannot be learned by the Razzivim, the undead. Interesting. So if you're an undead, you only get undead magic and no healing magic. Interesting. But as a general rule, they all are... mind is governed by personality, everything else is governed by intelligence. Let's look at our races then. There's Rasvim, also known as the Undead. The Rasvim are capable of becoming fierce warriors or dark mages. They have high resistance to poison and infection, but are vulnerable to spell-based damage. Ooh, that, yep, minus 50%. Magic resist is a big deal. They get the Unholy Word spell by default. Looks like, yep, definitely intelligence and strength with a cost of dexterity and personality. So they're not going to be great at mind magic. Aetherium. The Aetherium are natural hunters and have a high dexterity and increased accuracy with ranged weapons. They also have an innate magical ability that helps them harness magical forces. Oh. Not a lot of downsides. Reduced magical resistance, but you get plus 2 dexterity, endurance, accuracy, light weapon, light armor, disease resist, and you get a healing spell. That almost would work as a battle mage, just because of the lack of downsides and some bonuses to mostly the non-magic elements, I suppose. Siri. This race has long been regarded as the most talented in thievery and assassination amongst all the races of Monares. They are intelligent, perceptive, and have cat-like grace and are trained in useful thief skills. So very clearly a dexterity class. Yep, bonus dexterity, intelligence, and appraise. Even the money part. The Dearth are gifted scholars and teachers, and they can become the most powerful mages of all the races. While becoming stronger mentally, they're physically weaker, and are lacking in strength, dexterity, and endurance. So they lose all three of those stats, but they gain 10 to intelligence, healing magic, mind magic, and attack magic. They get cure light wounds and burning hands. Like, they just generally get a whole bunch of casting in general. But if you want to do any melee attacks or avoid dying for such reasons, you could be in some trouble there. The Nogur are the natural warriors of the races and are trained to fight from birth. They are physically stronger, extremely healthy, and have a high resistance to infection, but are vulnerable to magic attacks. A lot of characters in this game actually have negative magic resistance. Bit of a surprise there. So, if you want to go caster-wise, seems like the obvious options. There's the, Rasvim and Dearth. Dearth is nasty if you want to do any melee, to the point where it makes me wonder if I should just go full casting all the time. I would just be worried about completely running out of, I would definitely be worried about completely running out of mana. But it might be worth trying. I think I'm going to stick with Battle Mage and see how the shortcomings work. So let's see what the face options are. So there's there was the obvious ones, now there's a whole bunch of other ones down here. This guy. Oh man. Alright. There's actually a really long ongoing list here. This guy is just not happy to be here. Alright, some old school drawings and some silly ones. This guy's... looks like he's from Wasteland or something, and he just found that helmet somewhere. Yeah, I guess I'm fairly happy with the default for this case. That's an alright image for our mage. And the time comes to make up a name. Orist. I don't know where these things come from in my head, but apparently that's going to be my name. Male Dearth Battle Mage. With that, a face that only that cup that embedded in my head could love. What did I die in Riddick? Am I the teacup guy? Oh no. As you arrive, a village man is waiting for you. Welcome, my friend. I am Brill, a loyal servant of King Mersant. Hail to Mersant. We have been expecting you, although you're a few days late, and we had to use this underground tunnel to smuggle a dearth to the island. It seems Mersant really thinks the situation of the governor requires immediate attention. Huh. You don't really look like a kingdom agent, but you may learn. Ah yes, I have received your equipment. Just leave this cave through the western hole and you'll be fine. You receive your equipment. New quest? The main mission. I hopefully have that. Hail to Mersant! Hail to Mersant! Hail to Mersant! He just repeats it back to you over and over again. Why are you here? As head of the kingdom agents, Mersant's first line of loyal defense I and a few others have been charged with monitoring events on the island of Freymore and providing information to the king. Matras is a small village, so we can work in secret if only there were time to train you. The mission is perilous. I hope they have chosen the right one for the task. Tell me about the village. Matras is relatively peaceful. It's a pretty town, but the air is noxious and there is some small-time smuggling. You may want to get involved, but don't let it distract you from the main mission. You can stock up on supplies from the armorer, tailor, magic shop, and inn. Talk to people. Find out what you can. These villagers are loyal to Governor Hume and King Mersant. Hail to Mersant. Alright, tell me about the governor. Our worst suspicion is that he's been poisoned by someone who wants to control Freymore, but no one really knows what's going on. Matras is quite far from the capital of this island of Freymore, so you may find out more in Vasters, a city far south from here. Just follow the road. The Thieves Guild could be a valuable information source, but you may not be able to find them. You need to attract their attention somehow. No one should know your mission except those in Mersant's confidence. Don't forget, as far as anybody else is concerned, you're an adventurer from Barakel, even though you don't look like one. Alright? Goodbye. Brill leaves. And this is where I live now, huh? Oh. Hi, Bat. I took one step forward and we entered combat, huh? So immediately we have the tile-based movements that you've come to expect from a game like Legend of Grimrock, for example. So I can use this to cast spell. I have Cure Light Wounds. Stone Skin. How much mana do I have overall? If I click on my character, do I get that? Here, let's... If I exit out of here... There we go. Let's learn about my character a little bit. So, I have 40 hit points, 125 mana. That gives us some aspect of knowing... We apparently have a fame meter. But 125 mana gives us an idea of how much I actually have material-wise to cast with. So Stone Skin actually costs nearly a third of my overall list. Burning Hand, 18 mana. Curse. I have a few options here. Alright. Should I let it approach me? It's turn-based combat, so as I move around, it'll move around too. Here it comes. Hi, friend. I'm going to burn you now. Well, I won. That's one way to get rid of a bat, huh? But the portal... This teleporter is not active anymore. I am trapped here forever. Oh no. So that's how I got here. Hello. Yes, I will take that. Is that how you do that? You've taken... Here. Go ahead and leave here and go to my inventory. So was it this? Cure Poison Potion. Cool. And we have two small healing potions, one restore mana potion only for 40 mana, which is not a lot. Teaches Burning Hand, you already know this. Alright, I'm glad I have this spellbook then. Your storybook, oh, you're gonna read your own story. The races, volume 4, the dearth. So you can read about the dearth. Or I could misinterpret how to use that inventory screen. Sweet. Hide paper doll. Read book, there we go. The members of this race are considered extremely clever. Most are gifted scholars and teachers, and they shine in magic. They bond naturally with the energy currents that flow through the aether, and can channel powers that would damage the minds of other spellcasters. According to other races, these achievements lead many Dearth to think too highly of themselves. You can recognize one instantly because they are bald and their earlobes are missing. Alright, good thing I didn't change the portrait then, or it would have been very confusing if I didn't match what my whole class is supposed to look like. Your main but secret mission on the island of Freymore is to find out more about the missing governor and about an ancient prophecy called The Returning. You may get more information in the city of Asteres, where you need to attract the attention of the Thieves Guild. Governor Hume's castle can be found in the city of Mithra. But the entire main quest is talking about locations we're not even talking about going to yet for the first town. Alright. Any new bats around here? There's a hole. You wanna go, oh, that's how you go outside. Let's explore a little bit. After all, how many things could be trying to kill me around here, right? Oh, there's just a child around here. And I right-clicked, which apparently opens this... Interesting, right-clicking opens the menu. Are we in combat right now? Dramatic music for some reason. Hey, kid. Oh, there's the bats. That's probably why. Hey kid, how you doing? I am fine. Thanks for asking, Orist. May I ask the same about you? Who are you? Marisola is my name. I am Thurn's daughter. My dad is the Forest Ranger. He's the greatest Forest Ranger this world ever had. We live in a hut not too far from here. But what are you doing here? Aren't you afraid? There was a big storm. I ran into the hollow tree to keep from getting soaked. I was combing the rain out of my hair when I dropped my hand mirror. It fell right down here. I'm looking for it. I have to find it or my dad will beat me. He said he got it from a real princess. It's silver and it's beautiful. Will you help me look? Watch out for the bats though, they can bite. Maybe they got my sweet little mirror. Please help me so I can go home. Alright. I'll try, girly. Girly is the only thing I can say. You're such a big, wonderful hero. Thanks. Please hurry. I really want to go home. Alright, find Marisola's hand mirror. About your mirror. Oh, please, please, pretty, please find my mirror. There's no follow-up there. Hello, child. Don't mind me, just gonna fight bats for you. You guys... That's a were-bat? If it bites me, do I become bat? Is that a thing that can happen in this game? Oh, there's a... Hello. Oops. There's just a web here. Huh. So they can't come in here? No, they're just going back and forth over and over again. How about you? Anything to click on around here? Gotta get a feel for what kind of game this is and how much it might involve, like, secrets or not that other games have used. Well, if it's a spider web, logically I should be able to, Oh, you just attack it. There you go. Hi, friends! How you guys doing? Werebat seems threatening, so let's try to take care of him real quick. With Burning Hand. Jeez. Okay, fire spells are effective. It's the main thing I'm learning right now. Hey, friend. Are you here to make a murder? Let's try attacking. Alright, so there's his health bar down here. He took a little particle off. He's hurting me back, but I'm definitely hurting him faster than he's hurting me. That's a really unnerving sound he makes, though. Makes me just want to burn him again. But I'm trying not to just blow through all my magic right away, if I can avoid it. Maybe save it for the next time we fight a group. Is he just running away now? There he is. Now you guys are just being a pain in the ass. Alright, well now you're grouped up. Bye.
And then they were erased from existence.
You found an item of Crimini Vulgaris Mushroom. Alright. I've heard that there may be some English issues in this game just because it is a game developed by people that don't speak English by default. Hello. What's that? Oh, I can't grab it? Oh, cool. I'm trapped. Sweet. Just gonna go cleaving away for a little while. Make that magic last until I'm fighting groups of them at once or something. Die. One more. Got a few healing potions, I believe, so I can compensate. Hello, pool. Oops, I keep right-clicking to try to look around. This game's not rendered in 3D the same way as Grimrock and Fall of the Dungeon Guardians, so I can't really do that thing where if I can't already look at something, I don't think I can hold right mouse to drag it around and look around differently. Hello, giant pile of skulls. Nope, that didn't do anything. Alright. Might as well keep grabbing mushrooms. You never know when it'll be useful, right? I remapped the controls a little bit to make attack spacebar, because by default it's left shift, and I'm worried. I don't trust computers to react correctly if you hit shift too many times. Moonshine mushies. We're getting a lot of mushrooms here. Hello, money. The Wand of Great Burning Hand. Cast Burning Hand at skill level 60. Damn. That sounds like a very strong version of Burning Hand. And then, several coins? 8 coins. Alright. That's progress there. Probably won't use the Burning Hand for now, but it'll be handy at some point because I can use it against an enemy when I'm running out of mana, for example. And skill level 60 sounds like a really high level version of that skill. Spells. Burning Hand, 34 damage. Does it say what level it is? Let's see. Oh, skills. There we go. My attack magic. Oh, there we go. 29. So it would cast a spell that it's apparently twice as strong as my current one. All right. Besides the area map, the world map's also available. Click the world map button to see it. So this is a more zoomed out version. Then you can see the entire world altogether. Not relevant until I actually get to the overworld, but at some point. Hello? What are you? You found a book, the Primer Book of Fundamental Alchemy. Seems useful. Is this the one? Yep, teaches alchemy plus 3. You haven't read this book yet. Let's read it. Your alchemy skill has been increased by 3. That's good news. The skill of alchemy allows you to distill your potions and mixtures from various ingredients that can be found in the world. Refer to the ingredient chart for a complete list. Using your mortar and pestle, combine the ingredients carefully, and you will make unique concoctions. Each potion exerts a singular power when you drink or use it, such as healing you or decreasing your encumbrance. While you are still learning alchemy, be careful that your brews do not explode. It is painful to pick shattered glass out of your skin with a tweezer, and a bad explosion can kill you. While you are now an apprentice, by obtaining and studying the Alchemist's Book of Dark Sun Energy, you will enhance your alchemical skills and be able to create higher level filters. Holy Brew, healing, but not of an undead. Mix two of the following, just any two? Sprite's Breath, Old King's Folly, Power Berries, Seeds of Heaven, Lady's Slipper. Oh, there's a whole bunch of them here. Elysian Spirits restores mana, Devil's Demulcent restores health of an undead only. Witch's Scalpel dispels active magic effects. Levitation Elixir is Feather, like Slow Fall, I assume, or maybe Quiet Steps. Cleopatra's Oil cures poison, and Lightning Brew cures paralysis. That's an extensive resource to find this early on. Did the other one have multiple pages to it? No, it did not. Alright. You've already used that book. You've already read that book. You haven't read this book, but it's my story. We can leave that for now. And everything else is stuff I already know how to cast. Can I move these things around? No, you can't drag them around. That kind of stuff probably was... It's probably because it's from iOS. No, there's not really much reason you couldn't drag it around there. They just don't want to deal with that particular level of clutter, I suppose. So we're trying to find a hand mirror, huh? I don't see much evidence of that. There's a weird... Is that a button over there or something? Let us investigate. Oh, right, that's the loot location. This is where I start wondering where this hand mirror is supposed to be. Did I check everywhere already? Is it in my inventory right now? Does not appear to be. Alright, well, I'll loop around. I haven't checked this side yet, I don't think. Ah, no, those mushrooms are gone. That's a pretty good sign that I've checked already. Hey, kid. About your mirror. Please find my mirror. Alright. This child is going to die here, because I have no idea where their mirror is. Is it in the corpses? I would have hid it in the corpses. Is that a mirror? The weird... That's the mirror. You have found a beautiful mirror. You found an item of Marisola's hand mirror. Every time they say an item of thing, that's definitely them having a little trouble with English, I think. Or, I don't know, maybe it's just the terminology they wanted to use. Alright, we have the mirror now, though. Alright, so you click on them. About your mirror. Oh, sir, doesn't it look like a mirror that belongs to a true princess? That's me. Receive your royal kiss and your royal hug. You're so wonderful. I'll never forget you. My dad would have been so mad. Thanks. Here's all I have to give you. Water, some apples, and one of my little necklaces. I'll never forget how great you are. Oh, and one more thing. My mom and dad used to take me to Pagoda for fishing. They won't go now. But they won't go now. Rumor has it that an orc is terrorizing the bridge and won't leave. My mom's afraid he'll eat me. Or if you go by that area, will you get rid of that orc, please? The pagoda is quite a way south from here, though through the bushland near the lake of Brendan. I love it so much. I used to catch so many fish. Please try to kill the orc, and you can come back and tell my mom. I have to run now. Continue. Oh, wow. So you lost the mirror. We've solved the quest. New quest, Orc at the Bridge. We've got an apple, two apples, water, and a child's necklace, and increased fame. All right. Let's look at our fame. Whatever this stat means exactly. Now it's good. Slightly higher, apparently. We have a defined outfit of 10, apparently. There's gonna be some elements to learn about as we go on. So that's solved. So can I, let's switch to active mode, so the ones that I've already gotten rid of aren't showing up. Because that's just gonna clutter things up. So now we can do the main mission, or we can follow up on the, Orc at the Bridge. What's the necklace like? Weight 2, outfit regular. Might as well just wear it. I don't think there's actually any reason to wear it, but hey, my character... Does that affect my... Now I'm shabby, apparently, instead of threadbare. So that's a slight improvement. But also, it's just a nice little memento about that thing that I did. Yay. Let's go ahead and save. Because I don't have a save yet. There we go. That's nice. It gives you a little screenshot of where you saved. Alright, now let's go outside. Well, but don't have to worry about load times in this game, do I? So that's the tree she dropped her mirror into, coincidentally, and that seems to be the town we're here to meet. Oh, are we immediately under attack over there? I think we're immediately going to get attacked by some sort of archer. Yep. Ow! Rude. Ow. Why? Why must you? They're just coming across as rude at this point. Ow. Come here, lady. I'm coming for you. Okay, that's just getting... I don't appreciate that. Am I still out of range? There we go. Now who's scared? Ow. Dick. Burn! Now how do you feel? Oh, she's not doing great, as it turns out. Anyone else nearby? Safe for the moment? Alright, attack. And she's dead. And we get 50 gold, and most of my life is dead now. So that's not great. Let's go for that healing spell I had. Cure Light Wounds. There we go. Apparently I don't have that many hit points, so Light Wounds is all of the hit points. This game definitely has the Doom thing going on. Where all the stuff in the environment is two-dimensional, like these pools, and they rotate based on where you're facing. That's bound to delight some people and piss off some people. It's like, oh my god, look at it's like the old school graphics, and like, lazy developers, this is bullshit. I'm rather unopinionated oftentimes with that stuff. Are you friendly? You friendly? Ah, she's not attacking me yet. There's just a random enemy archer just hanging out right next to where she lives, apparently. Hello. Just name an Orist and I can do it. If I can do it, I will. Any problems, Nadia? Oh, apparently the way I phrased that was, everything is in order, dear. Thrum, my husband, is inside. I'm so worried about him. He almost broke his leg during one of his stupid hunts. He needs some healing ointment, yes, but I can't go and get it now. I would have to go to my father in his nearby hut. He knows the old lore of herbal medicines, but I must be with my husband, and it's dangerous out there nowadays. I saw some strange creatures roaming around the cemetery last time. Could you please go to my father's hunt on the plowland and bring the potion for us, kind adventurer? It'd be so wonderful. Of course, yes, just wait here. New quest, Nadia's potion. Thank you very much, brave warrior. You are our hero. We'll wait for you. Alright, so I think we're going to the, we definitely seem to be going to the Witcher 3 style approach of, straightforward dialogue, as opposed to the Divinity Original Sin approach to dialogue, where everybody talks for about 12 minutes straight for a quest that ultimately amounts to, go over there and click on that thing. I cannot attack a barrel. Do you guys get mad if I go inside houses? Oh, greeting, stranger. That's the room right there. Can I help you? Maybe you talked with my wife, Nadia, out there? She's always worrying about me too much. Yes, I injured my leg hunting. It can happen to anybody. But it's not the end of the world. I'll be fine. I'm in charge of overseeing the forests and bushlands in this area. Usually I can solve any problems here, but now with the sore leg, I would like to ask a favor from you. Are you interested? Of course. So the real problem here is that someone has been poaching the deer and other small animals of the southern forests and bushlands. I've heard rumors of archers infiltrating the environment. Some people say they have a cave, an Amazon cave, where their queen resides, around the River of Brendan. So please, find out more and rid that cave of these creatures. In return, I'll give you a reward. You can trust me. Now we have Thrum's quest for the animals. Alright, goodbye. So there's more to do just in this one little area. We've killed one archer already. It's weird that they call the archers creatures, because they seem to be human. To the west, the forest ranger's home. To the east, Hollow Tree. To the south, Village of Matras. Alright. I should probably visit the village, because I'm going to run out of potions pretty soon here, and I kind of need that to cast. Oh, hello, skeleton? It's apparently a skeleton. Oh, this is the cemetery. Maybe if I just go away. Oh, it looks like it's chasing me. I'm looking at it on the map. No, it seems to have given up on me. The enemies show up as red skulls on the map. Oh, he's still kind of following me. Maybe he'll leave me alone when I go to town. Just need to find my way in. We're in slow, clunky, turn-based moving right now because I'm being pursued by the enemy. Hello, friend. How are you doing, sir? Pass on, friend. It's a fine day. Alright, straightforward enough. Are you bored? Oh, hello, skeleton. And he is out of there. Oh, there he is again. Okay. That's a strange sight, isn't it? You know, let's go mess up a skeleton. How bad could it go? Ow. Go ahead now, good day. Shut up, guard. I'm doing things. Alright, Burning Hand seems straightforward enough. Unless he's resistant to fire, he is not. Ow. Got him. Alright. That's one less skeleton. Thanks for your help, asshole. It's great. Hello. Everyone's just kind of watching. She's all like, are you doing that because of the skeleton fight? You impressed or what? There's a child. All right. Hi, lady. Did not mean to attack. I meant to talk. I can delight your eyes, soothe your trouble, and cover you with a rain of kisses, sweet one. Lucia the Streetwalker. I can't afford much more than a peek right now. Can you tell me about the sickness? Can you confirm the rumors about the bad air here, dear? Yes, Adventure. I think I'm a worse situation than Brenda or Mayana here in the village. This street has the most smelly air because of some strange reason, but has some great and steady business too, so I'm staying. About the smuggling. I hear a sharp person can get a good deal on some of those rare goods in town, am I right? I might know something about that. If you throw me a few coins in return, I'll give you the information you need. Alright, here they are, just for your pretty eyes. Kisses, dear. So, here goes all that I know. They use the storehouse, which you can find in the port quarter. Most of the time, it's locked. But it has an underground secret entrance, as far as I know. At least, there are some rumors about a dungeon, too, where the sailors store the illegal stuff. But I don't know from where it opens. We lost two coins. Training, what? Lucia Streetwalker trains lockpick. For 136, you can increase your lockpicking skill. Interesting. Don't think I'm going to be using lockpicking, though. This not as an emphasis. This guy just has the coldest dead eyes, Mr. Beggar. A coin by Our Lady, one sweet coin. That is not what he looked like, by the way. That face model compared to what the person that I saw. If your pocket's sawdust, a piece of bread will do. Here it is. One coin. Thanks, stranger. Go with the beggar's blessing. Alright. Can I walk past you? No one's at that door. So you can just walk around and knock on doors. Can I light this torch? Nope. You hear a woman's voice inside. Settle down now, dears, or the great worm of the ocean will crawl out to take you, as he loves to gnaw on the bones of bad little children. Taking a look around. Hello, Brill. We meet again. You look fine, warrior. Don't forget your mission. Keep your armor in good repair and your nose clean. So this is the guy that let us in the first place. So it's the same questions as before. So he's the guy that I met with when I first came into this game. Prison of Matras. No answer. So that's where they keep the prison. That's just randomly cracks on things, huh? Even on the... How do you put a crack on wood that goes through all the boards? Maybe there just aren't individual planks. That part's all a lie. Yeah, the random cracks look a little weird. They probably looked a little less nonsensical on a phone screen originally. This poor dead-eyed man. Here, brave adventurer, here. Take a look at the craftsman's goodies. I'm sure you'll need some of them during your great adventures. What do you have for me? Look, nice, eh? Very fine ropes, some tasty food, or a strong wooden arrow. It's up to you, hero of the land. You can buy rope for 50, bread for 10, arrows for 75. I don't really use any... Then maybe later. I'll always be here, adventurer. I don't really need any of those things right now, but it's good to know they exist. Welcome to the village of Matras, alright? Might as well check around the houses. In true RPG fashion, hello, scary man. Nope, no one's in these outhouses. I mean, houses. Times must be hard for you, judging solely by the clothes you wear on your back. Some village man. About the village. It's cursed. The air smells bad. Ghouls and ghosts rise up in the cemetery at night. You leave here, go back where you came from. Gossip. My feet hurt and there's not even a good doctor in this town. Not much going on there. That's what I get for talking to someone that's literally just called Village Man and doesn't have a name. Village Woman. About the governor. Some say the governor's been poisoned by those who want positions of power when the returning happens. I know you probably scoff at the thought that the returning is anything but a myth, but many in Matras are believers and followers of the old religion. You'll notice statues here and there to the old gods. Many of us believe they're responsible for our crops when our crops flourish and when our women's bellies are heavy with young. Some say our bad air was brought on by the ancient's anger. Who knows? But know that the island of Freymore was the spot best beloved by the ancient gods. And if they were to return anywhere, it would be here. May the governor who follows the new religion anger... maybe the governor who follows the new religion angered him. Who knows? Alright, let's go meet the governor. And try to stop flubbing lines so often. There's a barber shop. There's an anvil, so that's the blacksmith. That must be the place where you buy mystical things and potions. That's straightforward enough. Alright. But who runs this place? That's a big, expensive-looking building. Jose, the innkeeper. Alright, there's an inn. Training. What do you train? Persuasion. That's probably not a bad skill to have. You can sleep here, you can play cards. Oh my god, does this game have a Gwent equivalent? You can choose the warrior, sorcerer, or necromancer deck. Let's do warrior. That sounds... I'll do sorcerer, true to my build, right? I'll bet 10. Alright. You play as sorcerer while your opponent plays as a necromancer. I have health 40. What do these cards say? Sandstorm inflicts 1 damage per turn, turns 5. Healing Shower heals 4 points. Moon Node, 25% damage bonus per turn, turns 4. I have 2 Moon Nodes. And Whirlwind inflicts 5 damage on the opponent and destroys one of his markers. Interesting. Does this game have a rule book for me to look at? Nope. It might have a place where it tells you how to play it somewhere, but I may have not found the tutorial. Let's do Sandstorm, that seems reasonable. So right now, so he did 5 damage to me, but Sandstorm is currently happening. So he's going to take an attack every turn. What did he do? Inflicts 15 damage for suffering 5 damage, so he hurt himself a little to hurt me a lot. Like a lot. 25% damage reduction per turn. Seems like a reasonable thing to throw in there. I have a really weak heal. I can destroy one of his markers, but he doesn't currently have one, really. Let's see. The bonus damage would help with the moon node. Let's try to reduce incoming damage, because I've taken a bad hit already. Ow. What did he do now? Drains 3 health from your opponent, so he's healing himself. 25% damage bonus per turn. Moon and death nodes. Alright. Let's throw in a node now. I have a few moon nodes just to use. He's doing it. He did Fang. Inflicts 6 damage for suffering 3 damage. He does a lot of self-harming skills. What did I get here? 5 damage on the opponent. Well, I have a node right now for bonus damage. Let's go for destroy. What are markers, though? I don't think he has one, does he? Let's do the normal 5 damage right now. There we go. He's keeping pace, though. He hurts himself a lot, which is weird. Inflicts 2 damage per opponent. Per turn? Fantastic. Oh, but it reset one of my... It got rid of my existing stuff, didn't it? So if you overflow, you're in trouble, apparently. Still, that's damage per turn. Let's see, I got... So he did inflicts 1 damage per turn for 3 turns. Combo card. You can table another card, which effect is doubled. Ooh, okay. Mana storm, and then heal. That'll double heal me, right? That gives me the lead. Reflects 25% of suffered damage. Inflict 5 on the enemy. Destroy one of his markers? Absolutely. There we go. Give him one less skill. Drains 3 health each turn for 3 turns. Ooh, gross. Heal 15 points, damn. That would have been a good thing to multiply on myself. I'm back up to 27. So you must be able to build decks or something. Regenerates health by 2 points per turn for 10 turns. Screw it, just keep spamming heals on myself. What are you gonna do about it? He inflicts 5 damage for suffering 3. Oh, he's healed up to 27 now. Look at that nastiness. How did he do that? Reduces the opponent's attack by 2 per turn for 3. Moon nodes. Reflects damage. This is kind of a mess right now. What did he do? Inflicts 5 for suffering 3. Let's do reflect. That turns the table and all of his attacks that he keeps using. He's hurt healing himself. Inflicts 3 damage per turn. Yeah, let's do that. Yeah, what'd he do? 5 for suffering 1. 33% damage reduction per turn for 4 turns. Let's just throw damage at him right now. Yeah. Try to make up the difference here. He's draining health per turn. Throw another set of knives will be handy. I gotta out DPS him at this point. Inflicts 8 damage. There we go. I'll take him. Oh, we're still really close. Could use a heal, which I probably don't have. Oh no, I have all these nasty percentage-based things. Yeah. I could try to reflect damage, but ultimately he can totally kill me. Reflect opponent's attack. Reduces opponent attack. Let's do that. 25% damage bonus. I need an actual attack, though. Let's reflect. I'm active. I'm up to 12 now. What did he do exactly? Inflicts 1 damage on the opponent each turn. Health 6. Oh, am I supposed to attack the blood golem itself? Inflicts 4 damage. What did he do? Defensive bone wall, durability 8. This guy has a messed up deck. I guess he's using necromancy. Damage reduction per turn. I have a lot of the same things. Damage reduction, damage bonus, damage bonus, damage bonus. Wow. Yep, a lot of the same kinds of spells. Let's try to reduce damage. I just need to do one good amount of... Oh my god. More damage reduction. What are you gonna do about it? Just hurt yourself a little bit. Inflicts 2 damage per turn. Come on, I have to get an offensive skill at some point, right? Let's see, anything... Are these all damage bonus? Damage reduction, there we go. I'll stack anything that reduces incoming damage, because all I need is one attack. There we go. He is not dead. He is gaining health faster than I can hurt him. Reflects damage. Do that. Okay, I can't even read some of these because they're going by so fast. Getting all these defensive bone walls. Let's keep healing. Combo card. Drain health. Stop it. Stop that. Destroy one of his markers. Absolutely. Wow, his health is back up again. I'm apparently very bad at this game. It doesn't help that I have the same... I have no cards. I'm just drawing the same thing over and over again. Is that 4 damage for suffering 1? Yep. Alright, I guess I'll stack offensive skills. It's a shockingly long game. I thought it'd be a brief one. Destroys all markers on the opponent. That's handy. I assume markers are these things. He has none, so it's not going to do me very good. Let's stack more damage. Just give me a nice offensive skill. There we go. Nope, still not. Damage reduction. Bummer. Well, the one he did is damage per turn. I can destroy that at least. You lost your bet. Alright, don't know how I feel about that card game. It's very long, and I didn't really have cool moves to do, because I was drawing the same cards over and over again, which is kind of a bummer. Let's talk to this guy. Did somebody die and leave you the clothes you're wearing? Nice to meet you too. Tell me about the inn. Rest your tired elbows on the bar and kick back a few beers. Sure. Our beds have a few fleas, but if you drink enough booze, you won't feel the little fellers and it will be totally refreshed. Just try it. Alright, gossip. Well, some beast or fiend is prowling the forests on the peninsula and devouring the animals. Even some of the forest dwellers have disappeared, rumor has it. Be careful outside the village. Some say they've seen mysterious shadows in the woods. Armed shadows. As you'd expect. Alright, this is probably a decent place to cut it, actually. So we met the townkeep. Sort of navigated the outskirts for a bit, but then made our way into town. Next episode, we'll have to meet the mayor and ask about his disease and proceed from there. Thanks for watching, like always, guys. I'll see you next time.